The cell envelope refers to the structure found outside our bacterial cell, and this includes the actual plasma membrane, it includes a cell wall, and in some cases, it also includes a second membrane, a second phospholipid bilayer, as we'll see in just a moment. Now, generally speaking, we have two different types of bacterial cells. We have gram-positive and gram-negative, and the way we differentiate between these two different types of bacterial cells is by using a technique known as gram staining. So before we discuss these two types of bacterial cells, let's discuss what the structure and the function of the cell wall is inside our bacterial cell. So the main function of the cell wall is to basically maintain hydrostatic pressure, to be able to resist the hydrostatic pressure that builds up within our cell. Now, because our cytoplasm of the bacterial cell contains many different proteins and other macromolecules, as well as molecules and ions, we see that the bacterial cell is actually found within a hypertonic environment. And that means we have much more solute inside the cell than outside the cell. And this means that water will flow from a low solute concentration to a high solute concentration. So water will flow as a result of osmosis into that cell. And as the water from the outside flows into the inside, that increases the hydrostatic pressure inside our bacterial cell. And what the cell wall actually does, as our hydrostatic pressure increases, as the turgor pressure increases, that cell wall is basically able to resist that increase in hydrostatic pressure. And so if that cell wasn't there, as our osmosis takes place and more water flows into that cell would eventually burst if it actually did not contain that cell wall. So the cell wall of bacterial cells basically functions to withstand the hydrostatic pressure that exists inside our cell. Now, in bacterial cells, the cell wall is made of a special type of molecule known as peptidoglycan. So peptin means we have some type of peptide bond, and glycan means we have some type of sugar molecule, and that's exactly what our peptidoglycan is. Peptidoglycan is a polymer of sugar as well as amino acids that create a mesh-like structure. Now, each disaccharide within our peptidoglycan contains several amino acids that basically connect to other amino acids attached to adjacent sugar chains. So to see exactly what we mean, let's take a look at the following diagram. So the cell wall is found right outside the inner plasma membrane. So let's imagine this is the inner plasma membrane. To that side, we have the cytoplasm. This small section is known as the periplasm. It's basically the fluid between our plasma membrane and this cell wall here. And this is actually our cell wall. Now, where exactly is our disaccharide unit? So the entire structure of peptidoglycan is composed of only two different types of sugars. We have the red sugar and we have the blue sugar, and this creates our disaccharide unit. And each disaccharide unit contains several amino acids in a chain. So this purple dashed line basically corresponds to our amino acid chain. So this is our disaccharide unit that contains our amino acids. And these disaccharides create a long polysaccharide chain. And these are connected as a result of a type of glycosidic bond known as the beta-1,4 glycosidic linkage. Now, notice that we have polysaccharide chain 1, polysaccharide chain 2, polysaccharide chain 3, and so forth. And these individual polysaccharide chains that themselves consist of disaccharide units are connected to one another as a result of cross linkages or cross links. So basically, these amino acids connect to one another as a result of a bridge known as the interbridge. So basically, we have one of the amino acids on this chain connects to one of the amino acids on this chain, and this is known as an interbridge. So if we, for example, zoom in on this region, we get the following diagram as shown. So the peptidoglycan consists of two types of amino sugars or sugars connected by beta-1,4 glycosidic linkages, creating a polysaccharide chain. So these are the polysaccharide chains, and these individual sugars are connected by beta-1,4 glycosidic linkages. Now, two or more polysaccharide chains, so one and two, so let's say these two polysaccharide chains are connected by cross-links between these amino acids shown in purple, and these amino acids are connected by interbridges. So we see that the cell walls of our entire structure within our cell envelope consists of this type of molecule known as, or this type of structure known as, peptidoglycan. And peptidoglycan, generally speaking, contains relatively large pores. And these pores or holes within our cell wall basically allow relatively large molecules to actually pass into this region here, which is known as the periplasm. So the periplasm actually contains different types of important enzymes, different types of important hydrolytic enzymes that break down different products that end up within this space, and that helps our bacterial cell actually digest and break down different types of molecules, which then are ingested into our cell. Now, earlier I mentioned that there are two different types of bacterial cells. So how exactly do we categorize different types of bacterial cell? So bacterial cells can be categorized based on their structure of the cell envelope, and we use a technique called Gram staining to basically differentiate between these two different types of bacterial cells. So we have Gram positive bacteria and Gram negative bacteria. So Gram positive bacteria contain a very thick peptidoglycan cell wall, about four times as thick as the actual plasma membrane. And because of this relatively large thickness of the peptidoglycan cell wall, when we actually stain our bacteria with some type of purple dye, that purple color remains within that cell because it cannot leak out of our relatively thick peptidoglycan wall. And so under the microscope, when we actually take our bacteria, the gram-positive bacteria, and stain it with the purple dye, those bacterial cells will appear purple under the microscope. So gram-positive bacterial cells are cells that are characterized by thick cell wall. When we stain the cell with our purple dye, the thick layer of peptidoglycan prevents the purple stain from leaking out back into our surroundings when we wash those bacterial cells with water. So under the microscope, gram-positive bacterial cells appear purple. Now, in both types of these cells, the periplasmic space, as I mentioned earlier, basically contains important hydrolytic enzymes that break down different types of molecules that are then ingested into the cell so that the cell can use them to basically function properly. Now, let's move on to the gram-negative bacteria. So the main difference between gram-positive and gram-negative is the thickness of our cell wall of that peptidoglycan layer. So these bacterial cells are characterized by a thin peptidoglycan cell wall. Now, because the cell wall is so thin, when we actually stain our bacterial cells with our purple dye, because the layer is so thin, that purple dye can easily wash out when we wash it with water. So that means under the microscope, all that purple dye will be removed after washing, and our bacterial cell will appear pink under the microscope. Now, on top of having a thin peptidoglycan layer, the other difference between gram-negative and gram-positive is that in gram-negative, we also have a second phospholipid bilayer found right outside our peptidoglycan cell wall. And this phospholipid bilayer is more permeable than our inner plasma membrane. So it actually allows relatively large molecules to pass through that phospholipid bilayer. For example, it allows sugar molecules to pass right through. And the sugar molecules, because the actual wall contains pores, will end up within this section, and then those sugar molecules can either be broken down by the hydrolytic enzymes, or they can be ingested directly into our cell wall. Now, another difference between our gram-negative and gram-positive is because our gram-negative contains this second phospholipid bilayer, that phospholipid bilayer contains special types of molecules known as lipopolysaccharides. So it contains lipopolysaccharides protruding from the membrane, which can protect the bacteria from being killed off by different types of drugs as well as antibodies found within our body. So basically, these types of bacteria can resist the different drugs that we develop in the laboratory to kill off the different type of bacteria cells found in our body. So basically, one important part that our cell envelope contains is the peptidoglycan. So basically, we can develop different types of drugs that actually break the crosslinks between our polysaccharide chains within the peptidoglycan, and that kills off our bacterial cell. Other different types of drugs that we can use can also break our bonds between the disaccharides, between this red and this blue, and that can also kill off our cell because once we break that cell wall, it can no longer resist that hydrostatic pressure that our internal environment of the cell actually contains. And if we break our cell wall, that bacterial cell will actually burst. Now, let's look at our description of the gram-positive and our gram-negative cell envelope. So the cell envelope of gram-positive basically contains the inner membrane, the phospholipid membrane, and a relatively thick peptidoglycan cell wall. Now, the gram-negative contains this inner membrane, a thin cell wall, and an outer membrane. And the outer membrane contains these polysaccharides, which are lipopolysaccharides, which are basically the lipids attached to long chains of sugars. And these sugars create a net negative charge around the entire cell, bacteria cell, and that protects it from different types of drugs. Now, we also have a section that connects the cell wall to our outer membrane, and this is our lipoproteins. So these brown regions are lipoproteins, also known as Brown's lipoproteins. And the entire or the main function of these brown lipoproteins is to actually hold together via covalent bonds the thin cell wall as well as our outer membrane. So we see that when we discuss bacterial cells, there are two main categories of bacterial cells. We have gram-positive and gram-negative. And the way we differentiate these two different types of bacterial cells is by the cell envelope. The cell envelope contains our cell wall, which is made of a material known as a peptidoglycan, and it also contains the inner plasma membrane. In some cases, we also have and outer plasma membrane. Basically, our gram-positive bacteria contain a very thick peptidoglycan cell wall, and that allows the purple dye to remain inside that cell. And that's exactly why on the microscope, these types of bacterial cells appear purple. But because of the thin cell wall of our gram-negative, that purple dye can be easily washed off, and so these gram-negative bacterial cells appear pink under our microscope. Now, one of the main functions of the cell wall made of peptidoglycan is to basically resist that hydrostatic pressure, that turgor pressure that builds up within that cell as a result of the hypertonic environment. Now, if we examine the outer membrane of our gram-negative bacterial cells, we see that we have these lipopolysaccharides, which play a very important role in creating a protective barrier around that bacterial cell.